Hello everyone, myself Mr. Sunil Dr.S.N.Kulkarni, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to deliver a video session on Types of Steam Condensers, Part 2. At the end of this session, you will be able to explain the construction and working of ejector type of jet condenser. Also, we are going to discuss the construction and working of surface type of condensers. The contents of this video session are ejector type jet condenser, downflow type surface condenser, central flow surface condenser, inverted type of surface condenser, regenerative type of surface condenser, and evaporative condenser. Now let us see the construction and working of ejector type of jet condenser. Now in this figure, we are seeing that there is an ejector type of condenser. The momentum of cooling water is used for ejecting or throwing out the condensate and air in this condenser. We can see that there is a one central tube, hollow tube, in which these hollow truncated cones, or which we can also called as converging nozzles, are fixed inside this particular central tube, and the cooling water at the head of around 5 to 6 meter is allowed to flow through this particular truncated hollow cones. When the cooling water flows through these particular converging cones, the velocity or kinetic energy of this particular cooling water will increase, and the pressure inside this particular central tube will reduce. This reduction in pressure will cause the exhaust steam from the turbine exhaust pipe to enter through the non-return valve into this particular central tube, and inside the central tube, the exhaust steam surrounds the water, and the cooling water and the exhaust steam coming out of the turbine will be mixed inside this, and this will cause the condensation of exhaust steam. Now for removing this condensate as well as air which is entering into this particular shell along with the air dissolved in the exhaust steam, this particular condenser is provided at the exit a diverging cone. This diverging cone reduces the kinetic energy of the condensate and converts into pressure energy, so that this condensate can come out of this ejector condenser against the atmospheric pressure. The main advantage of this ejector type of condenser is that it is very simple in construction and its initial cost is also very low. However, because the vacuum produced is not much high, this type of condenser is suitable only for small capacity plants. Now we will discuss regarding the surface types of condenser. In this, firstly we will discuss about the construction and working of downflow surface condenser. As we can see in this figure, the surface condenser of downflow type is having a cylindrical shell made up of cast iron, and this particular shell is closed at the each end with the help of covers to form the water boxes. Inside this shell, the tube plates are provided at each end between the condenser shell and end. Now these tube plates are provided with the water tubes, and in between the at the center of this particular surface condenser, the baffle plate is provided to divide the water flow into the two parts. So in this condenser, the exhaust steam is admitted from the turbine from the top side, and it will enter into the condenser shell. When this steam enters into the condenser shell, it will come in contact with the cold surface of the tubes because the cooling water is circulated through these tubes. Now the cooling water is circulated with the help of cooling water pump through the lower half portion of the condenser shell. It will flow from one end to another end, and then it will again enter into the upper half portion of the condenser shell, where it will return back and it will be going out. So when this steam, exhaust steam, comes into contact with the cold surface of the cooling water tubes, this gets condensed and the condensate is removed from the bottom side with the help of condenser extraction pump. Now this particular surface condenser is very commonly used in case of modern steam power plant, because the vacuum produced inside this condenser is of high level. Now let us see the construction and working of central flow surface condenser. Here we can see in the figure that this is a cross section of central flow surface condenser. The main difference between the downflow type surface condenser and central flow surface condenser is that the other construction is same. However, the air suction pipe in case of central flow condenser is connected at the center of the tube nest. Due to this, the steam which is entering from the upper side of the shell will flow toward the entire periphery of the tubes as shown by the arrow. This steam is drawn in because of the suction produced by the air suction pump, because of the suction produced at the center by the air extraction pump. So this steam will be touching the entire periphery of the tube. Therefore, the condensation will be effective. So central flow surface condenser is actually a modification, or we can say improvement, over the downflow type of surface condenser. Again, the condensate is extracted from the bottom with the help of condensate extraction pump. Now let us see the inverted type of surface condenser. The inverted type of surface condenser is similar to the downflow surface condenser, only with the difference that instead of steam is admitted from the top in case of downflow surface condenser or central flow surface condenser, here the steam is admitted at the bottom of the shell and it flows upwards. The air extraction pump is placed at the top in case of inverted surface condenser, and condensate flows down and it is removed at the bottom where the condensate pump is located. Now, what is regeneration concept in Rankine cycle? Let us pause the video for few seconds and think upon it. What is regeneration concept in Rankine cycle? As you are aware, in case of Rankine cycle, to improve the efficiency of Rankine cycle, the steam, when it is expanding in the steam turbine, it is bled at a certain point, and this steam is mixed with the help of condensate, which is coming out of the condenser, into number of feed waters. The feed waters used can be 2, 3, 4 or more, where the condensate is heated with the help of exhaust steam, and this regenerative concept is utilized for increasing the efficiency of Rankine cycle. So depending upon that, the another type of surface condenser is called as regenerative type of surface condenser. The condensers used in the regenerative method of fitting, which we have discussed just now, are called as the regenerative type surface condenser. In this type of condenser, the condensate, after leaving the condenser, is passed through the feed water heater and bled steam is mixed with it, and the temperature is increased. This gives us the advantage that the condensate at high temperature can be reused as a feed water to the boiler, which will result in the heat added in the boiler will get reduced, and we will get the higher efficiency of the boiler, and this will cause the increase in efficiency of the steam power plant, and it will minimize the fuel consumption. Now let us see the last type of surface condenser, that is called as the evaporative surface condenser. Now evaporative surface condenser is very commonly used when the quantity of cooling water available is less. In this surface condenser, the steam is admitted into the grilled pipe, and this steam admitted will flow through the grilled pipe, and the outlet of this grilled pipe or tube is connected to the condensate extraction pump, and this particular cooling water will be flowing or circulated with the help of circulating water pump, and it is spread over this grilled pipe. This spraying of the cooling water makes the thin film available over the surface of this grilled pipe, and when the steam is flowing through the tube, now due to the thin film form over this, the steam is getting condensed when it comes in contact with the cold surface of tube, as well as due to the flow of natural or forced circulation air currents, the steam is getting condensed, as well as the cooling water also gets cooled, because there is an evaporation which is occurring inside this particular condenser, and due to the evaporation of water, the cooling water also gets cooled, and this cooling water falls into the collecting tank which is placed at the bottom of this particular condenser, and thus we get the condensed steam as well as the cooling water in the at the same time, and this cooling water is circulated again and again. Evaporative condenser is very commonly used in the outdoor air conditions, and it is most suitable for lower capacity plants because the vacuum produced in case of evaporative condenser is also not very high. These are the references. Thank you.